Okay, well, all right. Hello, are we on? Is it on? Is this thing on? I'm Vernon Howe. You were watching this on YouTube.com, probably. This is called Drive Time. It's a television show that airs on Cable Access Channel 48 on every third Wednesday and every odd year in March. So that's the day you're on right now. I am pulling out of the gym right now. I got a mighty sweat on. I just passed one of these fucking cops in this town. These fucking cops. It's beautiful out, and it's just dusk. I would have liked to. I actually shorted my run from. I was gonna do seven or eight miles. I only did five just because I wanted to see if I could get home for my dog and walk my dog in this kind of red sky. It was slightly red in parts, still a little cloudy in parts. It was a rain out day. It was kind of wet, and I decided to just run at the gym after work and then go home and change out of this damp shirt. This is I'm sweating a lot more as I get older. I don't know what it is. When I run at the gym too, I sweat like a monster on the treadmill. And I'm just gonna put on a dress shirt. I'm not kidding about that. I'm gonna do that. So it's cold out there. Hot in here though. Hey, so sad. So I know probably from the angle that you're seeing this, you're just seeing kind of a dark sky. But I swear off to my right, there's a fairly, the sun's already set, but there's a hint of it in the right hand part of the sky. And by the time I get my dog going, it's going to be fucking blackout. And I miss this. But hey, you know. Yeah. You're living to learn. Yeah. This way. Been having a pretty good day. I know this is a big week in a lot of ways. I did, not that it matters to anyone, but I discontinued the fucking Pitchfork music project for a couple of reasons. I did get behind, I let it get behind. The prospect of catching up was at least a full day of like almost only doing that, and the amount, it's the most tedious fucking job, but it does annoy me to think that I scrapped it after putting so many hours, and it was probably, I don't even know, I don't want to think about it and even say out loud how many hours I was working on that. So that's the one hand. On the one hand, just the lost time aspect is not appealing to me at all. I feel bad about that, but The other side of it was more like it wasn't going anywhere. Like it wasn't the formula I had made that I was using to give a score to the Pitchfork reviews themselves. And I've realized that there's a good chance that someone watching this, whether it be now or the year 2045, especially in the year 2045, they're not going to have any idea what I'm talking about. So let me just quickly, if we have time, I'll quickly just say what I was doing. I was taking every Pitchfork review, and they review five per weekday. They review five records per weekday, very religiously. Their schedule, once from January to like, I'd say early December, maybe even mid-December, I guess they get into like the new year, they kind of recycle, they stop doing fresh reviews, I think. It's like, it's pretty much year-round, every Monday through Friday, regardless. It's like clockwork, five reviews, and I respect that, the work ethic of that. I, as one man, was attempting to parse, in a way, and I say the word parse, I know I wasn't really parsing anything, but I was scoring each review and I came up with a scale that I called pitchforkness. And let this little video be the only, I'll use the rest of my time here probably to talk about it, but let this be the only remnant on earth of what was once formerly known as, because I already deleted all the posts. So I wouldn't even read the reviews. I would read the reviews if I, a couple critics I do enjoy their writing, and a couple obviously if I had a interest in the band I would read it a little more closely. But mostly I was skimming, and what I was doing was skimming it for references to bands, other bands not outside of the artists who are being reviewed in said critique. So any, like, this was the Steely Dan of Bon Jovi's. So I would reference, I would count Steely Dan and Bob Dylan. So I kept a big master list that had hundreds and hundreds, if not over 1,000 by the time I quit 40 or so days into it. The list was unbelievably long of all the other bands who had been listed. And so I tabulated the this number. And if there was a couple things I would give, what I called them reference points. They weren't straight-up references, but I would score points for other things, too. So I had this little scale. So I would come up with a number of total references, is what I would call that. Then I would divide that. I would divide the number of words, total words, by references, so I get a reference per word count. So I think the highest reference, or, you know, the lowest, which was actually the highest density of references per words I ever got, was 25 references per word, something like that. So then I would, so whatever that number was that, and then I would score the entire review by a readability scale, and I would take the opposite out of 100 of the readability scale, kind of not foolproof, but I would create a, so basically if you're using big words, long sentences, the harder, the more difficult it was to read, you got this bigger number, and I would take that number and divide it by the reference per word rate, and then you would come up with the Pitchforkness score, and every critic, of which there were probably 30 or 40 within 40 days who were the only people who worked, maybe not even, probably 25, about people who wrote anywhere from one review during the year so thus far, or 25, I kept a rung tally of all their scores, and I would average out the people who had, you know, the Ian Coens of the world who were right, you know, two reviews a day almost, it seems like. And then that was your Pitchforkness scale, and then it was like, that was the project. So, the other reason I quit, other than being time consuming, was I didn't know why I was doing it. And I thought, like, I eventually would come to some, like, it'd be like, oh, yes, this is the higher meaning. I can put it into words now. Like, why would anyone be stupid enough to do this? That never came about. So that's ended Pitchfork Media Project, and thus ends my time with you, fair listener, fair looker, honor, watcher, person, till tomorrow.